Blackboard's rubric tool allows instructors to create rubrics for grading within the Blackboard interface. This presentation covers the basics in planning a rubric for use in Blackboard. A grading rubric is an effective way to communicate your expectations to your students about the quality of their work. Basically, a rubric is a scoring guide used in subjective assessments. Generally, rubrics include descriptors that specify the level of performance expected for each level of quality. Each level of quality is then assigned a specific value. Many times, a rubric is developed in a grid format, with the levels of performance listed across the top and the criteria listed down the side. Then, within each of the grid squares, the descriptors or specific attributes are listed. Here is an example of a rubric in grid format. Another style of rubric resembles a checklist associated with point values. In this case, the levels of quality and performance, called descriptors, are identified and assigned a specific point value. Here is an example of a checklist rubric. Blackboard's rubric tool uses the grid format. First, determine the things you want to evaluate. Often criteria will come directly from the assignment directions, lecture notes, or assigned readings. Some general areas to consider are quality, or the depth and breadth of the work, full coverage versus superficial coverage, inclusiveness of the work, all parts of the assignment are addressed, adherence to assignment directions. Try brainstorming all of the possible elements or things that could be assessed in the assigned task. Determine which are non-negotiable, and then prioritize them. These are your criteria, the row headers, in your rubric. Determine the number of levels of performance that fits the assignment. Two level fits a met or not met type of assignment. Three levels often end up with everything in the middle. Four levels is considered by many as ideal because it contains enough levels not to have a middle, but is not cumbersome or difficult to use. Label the levels. Some sources say to level high to low so that students read the highest level criteria first and may not read any others. Blackboard, however, has the default labels low to high. Here are some possibilities. Descriptors spell out what is expected of students at each level of performance for each criterion. If you are new to rubric development, you may find it difficult to articulate what each level would look like when applied to student work. Just do the best you can and plan on continuing to tweak the rubric for the first several versions of its use. Descriptors allow students to know what is expected of them and give you the ability to communicate to the student what can be done to improve performance. The descriptors also help you to more consistently and objectively distinguish between good and poor performance when evaluating student work. Here's how the Blackboard rubric looks with descriptors. Blackboard accommodates several scoring options. You may want to have a rubric with no points for student self-assessment activities. You have two options when it comes to assigning points to each level of performance. The points option assigns a single score for each level. The point range option allows you to identify a high and low score for each level. If the range between the two is large enough, you will get additional scores in between the high and low options. Blackboard also gives you the option to score an assignment by percentage. There is the single percent option as well as the percent range option. Both give you the option to weigh the criteria. The bottom line is that you will have to try the different options to find out what best works for you. Our best advice? Start simple and plan for revisions. These sources were consulted for this presentation: Jan Mueller's Rubrics and the Carla Center's Process, Creating Rubrics. Thank you for your time.